Satan is most powerful when he is subtle. Wow. And I'm going to tell you why. Satan is most powerful when he is subtle. You notice if you are trying to talk somebody into doing something against their will, you're not going to come at them in a forceful way because you'll push them away. You're going to try to ease your way in. Nothing wrong with being a car salesman or a car saleswoman. But you know, usually the first thing is, hey, how are you doing? I hope you're having a good day. So, you know, that kind of thing. And they just kind of reel you in, you know, like a good salesman will do. I used to sell suits. And I would do the same thing. I'd see somebody come in the door, and I would say, 34 regular, right? How'd you know? Well, because a man of your stature just looks good in a suit that really fits. Come here, let me just show you this. You know, you know, that's what you do. You figured I'd have to be some sales, but all preachers are, right? No, I'm just kidding. The fact is, that's the way the enemy works. And I want you to know, there's power and subtlety. In Genesis 3:1, the Bible says, the snake was sneakier than any of the other wild animals that the Lord God had made. Aren't you glad God refers to the devil as a wild animal? But you know what? The fact is, that man in the mirror is a wild animal sometimes. Because my flesh causes me to be a wild animal. So I forget that I've been born again every once in a while. I'm the only one I know, born again, child of God, Christian in this room, but sometimes their flesh gets the best of them. That's why I've got to make it a determine. I've got to determine in myself and make it a priority to choose Christ. Because my flesh is always going to be gravitating to that that I want, that my flesh craves. As 1 John says, I'll quote 1 John again, the lust of the eyes, the lust of the flesh, and the pride of life. Those three things are the three seeds of sin. It's what draws us away from God and to the enemy of our soul. Now, your enemy, the devil, you know, if you didn't know, he's like a lie. He's subtle. And a lie is subtle. So the devil is like a lie. That's why Jesus said he's the father of all lies, right? And he's a liar. The truth is not in him. Because a lie, when it's most powerful, is subtle. Let me explain. A lie is only powerful and effective when it is hidden behind anxiety, bitterness, hate, fear, and those kind of things. When someone crosses the line and just subtly suggests something about you that is not right, if you're not careful, your flesh will cause you to start getting upset about that because you're unsure of yourself. Maybe that accusation that your critic has made about you has touched a sensitive part of your life, or you're unsure about yourself. And because you're unsure about yourself in that area, there's a temptation to believe that lie. Why? Because the lie is suggestive. And because the lie plays on your weakness. The weakest part of your existence as a child of God is your flesh. It's your feeling. It's not my spirit, it's my feelings. And the enemy knows that. That's why he's subtle. And that's why he's a liar. Because he knows that subtle lie, that subtle suggestion is going to appeal to the flesh, and he can close the gap between him and us and give him more of an opportunity to have his get his claws in us and destroy us. That's why I have to wake up every morning with a determination in my spirit that I'm going to do it the Lord's way. There is a way that seems right unto a person, but the end is still and ends with destruction. Anybody know your Bible in the house today? You see, my flesh, even though I'm born again, on my way to heaven, my flesh still gravitates to what I want. And there can be times that I know that I know that I know that I'm right about a thing, but it's my flesh lying to me and convincing me that I'm right about it. Anybody? Amen.